For the fourth final exam question, we have another creative application of some concepts we've learned. We're going to deal with a three-body problem. Let's say that we have three stars, one with a small mass, one with twice the small star's mass, and one very large star with three times this mass. Given a certain initial 3D configuration of these stars, we want you to figure out how their position and velocity change with time. One piece of information that's going to be very important is this equation of the gravitational force between two bodies, which you should remember from our earlier units. To remind us that this force is actually a vector quantity, I'm going to be super explicit and put a vector sign on top of the F. Remember, all three of these bodies exert a force on one another. In the code, you can see that we've written out the mass of each star for you, as well as the gravitational constant, big G. We've dealt with everything concerning time for you. And all that's left for you to do is to implement the symplectic Euler method for the motion of the stars with the data provided above. Remember, the symplectic Euler method is a kind of half-implicit, half-explicit method. It will help you find the position and velocity of each star. Just so your results don't surprise you, this is a chaotic system, so you should get some pretty interesting looking graphs.